dear learners and all the honorable viewers, welcome to the online class arranged by Christo Gay Coppin Girls High School. This class is for class 5 and this is an English class. This class is taken by I am diplomat for assistant teacher Dr. Christo Gay Coppin Girls High School. My dear students, I hope you all are well and enjoying a good time. Do you like to read a storybook? In your EFT book, you will see there are two stories. Today we shall read a story. Before that, will you please tell me, or can you tell me, which animal is the fastest animal in the jungle? Okay, I think you can. The fastest animal in the jungle is the hare. Okay, and the tortoise is the slowest animal in the jungle. So, our today's story is, look at the board, the hare and the tortoise. The hare and the tortoise. It is unit 14, and you will open your page number at 54 to 55, and there are activities you'll see in 56 and 57. Before reading the story, we shall learn some new words, and you will note down the new words in your notebook. Okay, dear students, now look at the new words. Look at the new words written on the whiteboard. The new words are, the first new word is here, race. Race, a competition of moving first. A competition of moving first. Then, number two, a sleep. Means, it's an agility, it means in a deep sleep. A deep sleep. Then number three is nap. Nap, it means a short daytime sleep. Then, number four, furious. Furious. Furious means angry, and also there is another word you can write, agitated. These words are very important. If you know the meaning of the word, then it will help you to understand the passage, the story. Furious, angry, agitated. Then number five, win. Win. Win means succeed. And number six, speedily. Steadily, and write down happening gradually. Steadily means happening gradually, one by one, one after another. Then number seven, hurry up. Hurry up means do any work quickly. Do any work quickly. Then number eight, you see, it's a phrase. Hurry up is also a phrase. Phrase means a group of words which has a meaning, and it is idioms. You see, one on and on. It has different meaning. Means continually, that is doing something continuously, giving no gap. Okay, now you will write down the words in your notebook so that you can learn it, and also these words will help you to understand the text, the story. Okay, now dear students, I want to read the story so that you can listen to me carefully. After reading the story, I shall ask you some question, and also I'll discuss with you the pattern of questions which you will get in the exam. Okay, now you, all of you, take your EFT book and listen to me very carefully and open at page 54. In your picture, in your book, you will see some pictures. Very, very nice picture. You will see the first picture. What do you see in the first picture? Yes, you see a tortoise and a hare. The meaning of hare is, we can also say, and the word rabbit. Okay, dear student, please listen to me. One day, a hare was walking in the forest when he saw a tortoise. The hare was the fastest animal in the forest. The tortoise was the slowest animal in the forest. I told you before that the deer is the fastest animal and the tortoise is the slowest animal in the forest. The deer called out of the tortoise, "Hurry up, you are so slow. Can't you walk faster? Can't you run? You see, here the deer is asking the tortoise to do something." Okay, the tortoise felt angry and said to the deer, "Why don't we have a race? You know the meaning of race here. I have written for you a competition of moving first. Why don't we have a race? Maybe I can win." Okay, next para, you see, the deer laughed and laughed. "Sure, I will win," the deer said. They agreed to start next to a big tree and finish at the river. Then they called their friends to watch. The deer stood beside the tortoise and the race began. Now, go to page 55. There is another picture, you see. What is the rabbit doing here? What is the deer doing here? And what is the tortoise doing here? Look at the picture first very carefully. Okay, now I'm reading this part. The deer ran quickly and in a few minutes, the deer was out of sight. It's also face out of sight, that is invisible. We all know the deer can run really fast. And so within a few minutes, the deer do what? That deer went out of sight. The deer was not visible. The deer said to himself, "The tortoise is very far behind. I can see the finish line. I have time for a nap." I think you know the meaning of nap. The nap means, the word nap means a short daytime sleep. A short daytime sleep. So, who napped? Yes, you have seen here in the picture the deer napped. "I have time for a nap." Soon the deer was asleep. Here the meaning of a sleep is, you have seen already, in a deep sleep. Under a tree next to the path, the tortoise walked steadily on and on. On and on means continually, without any stopping, without giving any gap. Now, he didn't stop. Soon, he passed the sleeping deer. You see, the deer is sleeping. Okay, the deer slept for an hour. When he finally woke up, he looked at the finish line. He could not believe his eyes. Tortoise was almost at the finish line. The deer ran as fast as he could, but it was too late. The tortoise crossed the finish line and won the competition. The deer was furious. Look at the word furious. Furious means angry or agitated. Angry, very angry. The tortoise looked back at the deer and smiled. Then he said, "Slow but steady wins the race." It's a moral of the story. Actually, from the story we can learn something. This story is also gives us a moral. And the moral is what? The moral is slow but steady wins the race. Okay? Now I have finished reading the story. I think all of you have listened to me very carefully. So I told you before that after reading this story, we shall do some activities. Now you, my dear students, you open at page 56, okay? And we shall do activity B. Dear students, I think all of you have opened at page 56. Read the sentences. Complete the questions. Actually, in the question paper, in number 9, you will see that there is making questions, WH questions, and you have to learn how to make WH questions. In your question paper, you will get this type of question in number 9, and this is here included. Read the sentences. At first, read the sentences. After that, you have to complete the questions. That is, you have to make questions. Okay. Now, I am writing the sentence first. The year. You can say these WH questions. Making WH questions. You will get the activities in your book, page 56. The year was lucky. Walking in the forest. Okay, look at the word. Look at the underlined word. And also you can read another questions if it is underlined. We can make two questions for you. If we say the here, then you will make questions in this way. You will make your questions using WH words. Please state a sentence you can say and the question, who was lucky? In the first. You must put question mark at the end of the sentence. As it is a question sentence, you must put question mark at the end of the sentence. Otherwise, it will not be a correct interrogative sentence. Okay, who was working in the forest? And if in the question paper the word is not underlined, and this portion is underlined, this phrase is underlined, then how will you make the questions? You have to then make the questions in this way. Let me raise this question. Can any one of you tell me? Okay, I know you must tell me, or you can tell me, answer me correctly. Where it denotes, it indicates the place. For the place, you have to bring the word where. Where? In your book, you will get question like these. And look, here the word here is here. In your book, it is written, already written. So, after here, after where, you will write where was, because at the time of making questions, after the base word, you have to bring the auxiliary verb. Bring the auxiliary verb. Where was the here walking? You must not write this portion because you will ask questions for this answer. The answer is in the forest. Where was the deer walking? And put, you must put question mark, okay? Where was the deer walking? Now number 2. In your book, you have the sentence number 1 and number 2. Number 2, the hare saw the tortoise. I am writing the statement first for the better understanding of the question pattern. Because in the question paper, you will get sentence, first the sentence, and you have to make questions. So it is called making WH questions. The hare saw the tortoise. It is a statement, it is a sentence, and you have to make question. What was the question in your book? You see, what do you see in your book? There is a the base word written before. So what is the word? The word is what? Dear students, do you see the word here in your book? Okay, I think you can see. So the question will be, what is written word? Did the tortoise see? Look, you must keep in mind about the tense here. So, so is the verb and it is in past tense. As it is in past tense, you have to bring an auxiliary verb, and the auxiliary verb here is did. What did the tortoise see? And you must not write saw, because in a sentence two past form of verbs are not used. So if you write here did, you write did here, and you write see at the end. What did the tortoise see? Okay, now come to question number three. Here, how is written? I like first one to read the statement or the sentence. The tortoise was walking slowly. The tortoise was walking slowly. Here, past continuous tense is used. Walking slowly. Question paper, when you will get this type of question in your question paper, you will see that the words are underlined, but in the book it is not underlined. For understanding the question in the question paper, I am doing this slowly. You see in your book that how is already included, written. So how shall we make the question? The question will be, the question will be how. Slowly means how. It's an adverb. How was the tortoise walking? How was the tortoise walking? How was the tortoise walking? You must not write down the word slowly in your question, because you have written how for slowly. How was the tortoise walking? Okay, now go to number five. What is the statement or what is the sentence? The sentence is, here you see, the sentence is here. The here, when you see, it is, you can say statement or sentence, same thing. The deer went to sleep. The deer went to sleep. As it is a statement or sentence, I have put full stop at the end. Okay, your students, do you get the point? Am I clear to you? As it is a sentence or statement, after statement we use full stop. Okay, the deer went to sleep. Look, in the question paper, the word will be underlined. The question paper for making the base question, the word will be underlined. But in your book, it is not underlined. And here, who is already written. So we see the subject is here. The subject, the here. So we make the question by using what? By using who. Who went to sleep? Who went to sleep? And which mark we shall use? Yes, you are right. We shall use question mark. Who went to sleep? Now, number six. He slept for an hour. He slept for an hour. So, it is said that he worked for this time. He asked time. How long? Number six, you see the statement. I should write the statement first. The statement is, here the statement is, he slept for an hour. He slept for an hour. It is underlined for an hour. For an hour, you have to think for an WS word. What is the WS word? Yes, in your book, it is written, dear learners, you see, how long he slept for an hour. How long? Okay, I am raising the other sentences so that you can understand easily. Look. The statement is here, he slept for an hour. It is asked time. For time, which word we shall write here? Okay, we shall write, the question we shall write, how long? Yes. For meeting questions, we have to bring an verb, auxiliary verb. So, which tense is used here? You see, slept, past tense is used here, isn't it? Okay, so which auxiliary verb shall I write? Can you tell me, dear learners? Yes, I think you can tell me. Yes, right, did. How long did he sleep? Okay, now, number seven, you see number seven, it's a long sentence, statement, you write a statement, the statement is here, yes, the year woke up, it's also past tense, when the tortoise, when the tortoise crossed the finish line. The tortoise crossed the finish line. The question paper may be underlined. It will be underlined like this when the word when is conjunction here, not the question word. Look, the deer woke up when the tortoise crossed the finish line. Dear learners, which question word shall we bring? And in your book, you will see it. It is when. So, how will be the answer? The question, that is our task, is making question. When, as it is past tense, did. When did the deer wake up? We write wake up. Because we shall not write woke up, the two past form of verb in a single sentence. Look, when did the deer woke up? Because we see that in this sentence, past tense is used. For this, we have to be, yes, in your book, when is used, when is written, after when, you will write for past tense, the auxiliary verb did, and the subject, the here, and woke, the verb wakes, present form. Yes, it is woke, it is wake. Woke is the past form, and Wake is the present form. You have to write when did the deer wake up. Okay, the last one. We have come to the last one. The tortoise on the days. Okay, the statement is, I'm writing the statement. I'm writing the statement because from the statement you have to make question. The statement, yes, it is number 8. Look at you, it is number 8. The statement is here, the tortoise. The tortoise won the race. We know the meaning of win, present form of won. Win means succeed or get the prize. Yes, I'm putting stop at the end. The tortoise won the race. Okay, now what will be the question? Can anyone tell me? Yes, I think you can. I think you can tell me, and the deer's word which we shall use is written in your book. You see, look here, the word is, okay, now before that I want to underline the word, who, on which subject or on which word you should make, you will make a question. You will make a question on this word, the tortoise. The tortoise on the leaves. So what will be the word? The deer's word, you shall bring. You should write who won the race. Actually, we shall not bring it here. Why we shall not bring it here? Because we shall make a sentence on subject. If we make question on subject, we need not use this structure like this. When did the ear wake up? Because in this sentence, you see, we make questions on object. On object, but here is subject. As we are making questions on subject, we did not use this structure. So you only write who won the race. Who won the race? And put, you must put question mark. Otherwise, you will not be a correct sentence, correct question sentence. For making question sentence, you must put question mark at the end of the sentence. Okay, now dear students, I think you have understood this portion, activity B. You must write down this portion, this activity in your book. Now come to the section C. Read the sentences. Which animal is each sentence about? I think you know about, here you know about tortoise. Tell me, or you have to write beside the sentence in the underline, which animal is each sentence about. He is the fastest animal in the forest. Yes, students, can you tell me? Yes, I think you can tell me. He is the fastest animal in the forest, the hare. The hare is the fastest animal in the forest. You will not write the full word. No, write T for tortoise or H for hare. Okay? Number 2. He is the slowest animal in the forest. He is the slowest animal in the forest. Who is the slowest animal in the forest? I think you know. The tortoise is the slowest animal in the forest. He took a nap during the race. Who took a nap during the race? Dear students, I think you know. Yes, you are right. The hare took a nap during the race. He crossed the finish line first. Who crossed the finish line first? Yes, the tortoise crossed the finish line first. Though the tortoise walked slowly, he finished the cross line first. Can you tell me what is the reason? Because he was walking steadily, walking on and on steadily without giving any gap. Now the last one. He was angry at the end of the race. Who was angry at them at the end of the race? Can you tell me? Yes, I think you can tell me. Yes, the hare was angry at the end of the race. Okay, now look at the question D. And you will and look at the question D. I am reading the question loud so that you can answer. What does slow but steady wins the race mean? It's a moral. You have to explain. You have to write at least two sentences. What does slow but steady wins the race mean? Okay, now come to E. It's the gap filling activity. Fill in the blanks with the correct word from the box. You see there are how many words you see? You see there are 7 words. Fastest, first, raised, slowest, steadily, to 1. Yes, I am reading it out. You will write down it in your notebook. Okay? The hare was the fastest animal. But the tortoise was the slowest. One day, the tortoise and the hare raced. The hare ran very quickly, but then he took a nap. The tortoise walked on steadily. While the hare was sleeping, the tortoise passed him. The tortoise crossed the finish line first and won the race. I think you have got the idea, got the story, and also the gap filling activities. You must write correctly in your notebook. Okay, then F, matching. In your question paper, you will get this activity after the passage, the activity will be given for you. So you must be very careful at the doing these activities. Look, you have to match. For do the activity correctly, you have to know the meaning. You have to learn some meaning of the words. You have to keep it in mind. I told you before. You look in column A. In A, there are 5 words. The words are angry, first, nap, next to start. And in B, you see there are some words, 5 words, begin, beside, furious, quick, sleep. Now let us match the words with column B, angry. Which will be the correct word? Yes, furious. Angry means furious. First, what will be the first meaning of first? Quick. Quick, then nap. Nap means sleep. Next to means beside. Then start. Start means begin. Okay, dear students, now underline. Look, there is a grammar focus and it is question quotation marks. Quotation marks. You see, G quotation marks. We use quotation marks to show what someone said, quotation marks. Let us see where quotation marks is used. Yes, it is. In your question paper, we have to write the punctuation marks very correctly. Is quotation marks. Quotation marks. This is the punctuation marks. You know, there are many punctuation marks, full stop, comma, and also quotation marks. Now we will discuss about quotation marks. In your book, you will see at page 57. If I say, I have said to you, how are you? what position marks? Yes. Use of quotation marks. You have to know about, your students have to know about use of quotation marks. Yes, you will see in your book, use of quotation marks. Okay? I have written, I have said to you, how do you? When speaker's speech is directly written, then we use it, we use quotation marks. It is my speech, how do you? Directly it is written here, so then the time of this, we shall use quotation mark. In your book, I'm reading it out. We use quotation marks to show what someone saying. I'm saying what someone saying. How are you? So I have used quotation marks. We put quotation marks at the beginning or at the end of the person's words. It is my words. How are you? Use a comma before or after quotation marks. Start the first word inside the quotation marks with capital letters. Look, you have to use capital letters here. Then there is an example. You see, the hare said, I am the fastest animal. The hare is the speaker here. The hare said, comma, and use quotation mark. I am the fastest animal. And you can also write in this way, I am the slowest animal, said the tortoise. So quotation marks can be used at the end of the sentence, or also it can be used at the beginning of the sentence. I am the slowest animal at the, said the tortoise. Okay, now I think you have got an idea about use of quotation marks, and now it is time for taking homework. You will do these homeworks in your notebook. Activity is, you will make it, you will write it at homework. Underline the sentences with quotation marks on pages 54 and 55. You will read again page 54 and 55, and you will underline the sentences with quotation marks, and you will also write down the sentences in your notebook, in your exercise book, so that after the school will reopen, when will the school reopen, I should check your homework. Okay, now let us finish here. I hope you have enjoyed my class, and you will do the homework at home, and at home very carefully and also correctly after reading the text. And let us finish here, and you will stay home and stay safe. Okay, goodbye. See you again.